Good evening, Kona delegates, and welcome to episode 3 of the Blue Ridge Journal broadcast. I'm Ariana from the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And I'm Dylan with New Hampshire. What do you think about the breeze this morning?
It's definitely better than hot and humid. Let's go over to Soleil and Lila for tomorrow's weather.
Hey, did you hear about the weather today?
Tomorrow!
It's like a roller coaster ride from 82 to 59 degrees.
Yeah, and it's like Mother Nature can't make up her mind. And no rain, it's like the clouds are on vacation.
Don't forget about the UV index. It's like the sun is playing a game of burn or tan.
And that humidity, it's like we're walking through a giant bowl of soup. Slippery sidewalks, here we come.
Oh, and the bear sightings? It's like the forest decided to invite some unexpected guests to our picnic party.
Bears, sunscreen, frizzy hair, and sweat. Sounds like a recipe for a wild adventure.
Thank you guys for that. Now let's take it over to find out about some of our delegates' favorite traditions. What's yours?
Definitely not the annual surprise thunderstorm.
Yeah, not fun. My favorite is definitely pin trading. New Mexico, hit me up. I'm still looking for that UFO. Chloe, take it away.
My favorite Kona tradition is cheer wine. When I go home, I can drink it and think of Kona.
My favorite tradition is Seersucker Tuesday.
And mine is on Wednesdays we wear pink.
My favorite Kona tradition? Watching the sunrise on the Eureka Porch steps. It's like unreal. And I think this is what Kona's all about.
My favorite Kona tradition is the fire ceremony because it's a great way to close out the trip.
My favorite Kona tradition would probably be the state chants. It's a great way to feel unified with your delegation and have a sort of fun competitive spirit in between committees.
I think my favorite tradition is the loud alarm they play. I think it's at like 7 in the morning. The second night, there's like a desk on my bunk bed. And I jumped up so hard, I hit my foot on it, and it has been hurting ever since, and walking sucks.
Trading.
Okay, my favorite tradition is on the campfire that we do at the end of the week, because it's a great time for reflection.
Thank you, Chloe. And happy Seersucker Tuesday to those who celebrate. This year's debate was definitely a big point of interest. Now let's hear some first-time voters' opinion on the presidential debate.
Hi, I'm here with...
Sam Slack, New Hampshire delegation.
Elin Van Duzer from Washington State.
Isaiah Graves from the Michigan delegation.
Brandon Pollock from the great state of Ohio.
What were your thoughts on the recent presidential debate?
I thought the recent presidential debate could have gone a lot smoother and could have been a lot more respectful. I feel as though a more respectful debate would shine a more positive light on our country.
Yeah. I thought it was really chaotic and it kind of stressed me out. And I want to see like more debate so that it can help like clear my mind a little bit.
Definitely a sad look on our country on both sides. To me, I couldn't pick a winner, but I could pick a loser, and that was obviously the American people for sure.
Honestly, I was really disappointed at both sides of the aisle. I think that we need better candidates and younger candidates as a whole.
Has it changed who you're gonna vote for?
It has changed who I'm gonna vote for.
I'm not sure, honestly.
No, this debate has not changed, but you know, I'm always willing to listen to people and you know, maybe you know, someone else who has a different experience may change.
Yeah.
It did not change who I was going to vote for. I'm still planning on voting for who I'm planning on voting for, but I could definitely see how an independent voter could be affected by the debate.
Do you feel prepared to make an informed vote in November?
I do feel prepared to make an informed vote in November.
To be honest, no, I don't. I think I need to see more from both candidates because I feel like it wasn't a really great representation of like, maybe it was a great representation, but I don't think it was like the best thing that the country could put forward.
Absolutely. I think seeing how our country looks now and hearing from so many different people from both sides, I do believe I can.
I think I do. I'm somebody that pays really close attention to politics, and I do think I'm ready to make an informed decision.
Now we hear from our very own and wonderful presiding officers on some first-time voting advice they wish they would have known.
Hi, everyone. I'm here with some of our great POs, and they have some advice for first-time voters.
Hi, my name is Gabby. My advice for first-time voters would be, especially in local elections, not to just go down the ticket. I really think it's important to research each candidate individually to make sure that the people that you're voting for are people that you feel can represent you well.
That's amazing. My name is Noor. My advice is along the similar lines as Gabby's. It is to pay attention to judicial elections. So that would be all of your county judges, all of your city judges, everyone who is up for election in the judicial branch, please pay attention because those are the individuals who will be deciding Supreme Court applications and stuff like that in your state.
Hi,
Hi guys, I'm Leah from Pennsylvania.
And I'm Soleil from New Mexico.
We're going to the Eureka Snap Shop right now to try the new Rice Krispie Eureka Treat.
They're coming out tomorrow, so come try it with us.
Hi guys, we just got them. Soleil, what do you think?
Let me try it. It's so good. I love this. What do you think?
I also love it. I say get it with the marshmallow on top. It's really good. Yeah.
Go cop yours tomorrow.
Red wine. Let's go to the beach. Each, let's go get a wave. They say what they gonna say. Have a drink, clink, found a Bud Light. Bad bitch like me, it's hard to come by. The Patron, oh, let's go get it down. The sound, oh, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it 2, 3? Leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't give a
I'm on the floor.
Seeing everyone come together. Dylan, what made you smile today?
Henry and Simon from Minnesota. What you know about a chicken parm? How about you?
Definitely my bestie Eureka the orange. Let's give it off to Emily for shoutouts of who made Delegate smile today.
Hello, my name's Lola.
My name's Aaron.
We're from the golden state of California. My voice is gone, and someone that made me smile this week is Brady Sternberg, goofball from Minnesota. Funny guy, really good taste in music.
Someone who's made me smile, my committee best friend, Mary from Alabama. We were close on the mountain last year and even closer this year.
Boom. So, hi, I'm KJ. I'm obviously from the great color state of Maryland. And someone who made me smile, it's a combination between New York delegation and New Hampshire delegation. They made me smile the whole way on the bus. I love their delegations.
My name is Verity Gray. I'm from New Mexico, and somebody who made me smile this week was Aurelia, the PO from New Mexico.
Anoki Patel, New Jersey delegation, and someone who made me smile this week was Avery Smith from Missouri.
Alyssa Julian, Louisiana, and someone that made me smile this week was Emily, who took our pictures by the pretty mountains.
Shreya Seshadri, New Jersey delegation, someone who made me smile this week was Lila from Minnesota.
I'm Emily Kearns, and if that made you smile, make sure to tune into episode 2 of our podcast, Our Voices Amplified, coming soon for more smile shoutouts.
Well, that's a wrap on Tuesday night's broadcast. Thank you guys for tuning in.
Be sure to check out BRJ Kona Instagram page and our podcast, Our Voices Amplified, for more content.
Make sure you get sleep, stay hydrated, and be safe.
Peace.